Hello, it's Scott Manley here. Now, in honour of Asteroid Day, I've done something rather special. So this is a 360 video. If you don't know how to watch them, you should look at my other guide video. But the idea here is that you're standing and looking around, and in the night sky above you, you can see all the stars. Well, below you, I can get rid of the horizon, and you can imagine that you're now floating in space at the location of the Earth. You might be able to pick out some planets there, and the Sun, which is the yellow fuzzy object. I'm sure you know what the Sun is, right? So you can see the five planets that are visible from Earth: Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn. And you might be able to pick out some constellations. But because this is Asteroid Day, I want you to be able to see the asteroids. So I'm just turning on the asteroids and making the asteroids near the Earth visible as if they were stars. Normally, asteroids are not visible to the naked eye because they are so small and faint. Now, this is the 5,000 or so asteroids nearest the Earth, and at this point, you might not be able to tell the difference between them and the stars behind them. But what I can do again is I can alter time. I'm going to make time run faster and faster so you can start to see the motion of these asteroids as the Earth moves around and these move relative to the Earth. The time here is running around 2.5 days every second, and you can see them following their paths, flying near to the Earth and going away. Obviously, their motion is a combination of the Earth's motion and the asteroid motion. And those which are moving fastest across the sky are the ones which are passing closest to the Earth. Now, I should stress that these are only the known asteroids. By some estimates, we may have found about 1% of the near-Earth asteroids. And one of the reasons for this, well, you can see one of the reasons. If you look towards where the Sun is, you can see there are a few asteroids floating around there. Well, normally you can't point a telescope at the Sun. So if you imagine that there were undiscovered asteroids flitting through that space as they came close to us, we would never discover them. If you actually look away from the Sun, you'll see there are a lot more asteroids hanging out about out there, and that's in part because of this inability to discover objects that spend most of their time interior to the Earth's orbit. Now, there is a space telescope concept called Sentinel, which is being championed by the B612 Foundation. This would put a telescope between the Earth and the Sun, and it would be able to discover many, many objects that we could not see from the Earth. And the reason, of course, that you want to discover these objects is that potentially some of these could hit the Earth. And we'd like to know if this was going to be the case. Right now, we're essentially flying around the Sun through this population of asteroids with our eyes closed. And that's why I'm advocating for more resources to be put into this task of discovering and cataloguing this population of potentially hazardous asteroids, so that we can know if something really does have our name on us, or so that we can sleep soundly in our beds at night knowing that nothing's coming our way. I'm hoping you'll join me and many, many more distinguished signatories in supporting this cause. I'm Scott Manley. Fly safe.